Peace and blessing. What's up, everybody? Hey, it's your boy Chaz from the Chaz Wynn Show on Grind City TV Network, Roku. Happy Wednesday. It's hump day, y'all. And I gotta say, it's been one of them weeks. It's been an up and down roller coaster week. You know what I'm talking about. The kind of week where, you know, your morning coffee just ain't, it ain't quite getting it by itself, and you need a little this extra. When you need a little bit of extra in your coffee, man. And I can't say it was a totally bad week, but it was a little bit of a struggle to get through this week. You know what I'm talking about? I'm talking about the kind of week where no matter what, you know, you just, everything wasn't just right, and I think I'd be doing too much. You know, I couldn't quite get my edges weren't on point this week. My edge gel ain't working. I gotta have to get some new Ultra Gel. You know what I'm talking about. One of them weeks. It wasn't like a real, real bad week where you gotta go get your Crown Royal bag and roll up all your pennies and put them in there and go on down to the Corn Star kind of week. It wasn't that exactly, but it's just, everything was just amiss. You know what I mean? I think, like I said, I'd just be doing too much trying to get to everything. So I gotta fall back sometimes. And you good people, there's always somebody out here that reminds me of that. Take a break. You know, hit the reset button, start over. So I like to do my favorite things to just keep getting my motor again. You know what I'm saying? Just keep on going. And the truth is, you know what? You're going to have them days where everything you do just ain't going to be right. So it might have been a movie, Life. You know what I'm saying? Eddie Murphy, they had the Joaquin Woodbine, Can't Get Right. You know, you sometimes going to feel like Can't Get Right. But this is what I do. You know, when I want to refocus, reset myself, I want to stay on my grind. I go old school. So I don't never iron my pants. But, you know, when I put these old school OG creases in here, you know I mean business. So that's how I'm coming to work today. Put the little, you know what I mean, get them razor sharp creases, Niagara starch, you know what I mean? This is how I'm going to do it today. I'm gonna be extra crispy today. Please, Alexa, play. Alexa, play. That's right, y'all. Saint is just a sinner that fell down them steps. I'm gonna quit. For real. Alexa, stop. But y'all get the picture. Welcome to another edition of Chaz Wins on Grind City TV Network Roku. I'm your host, Chaz Burke, and it is a blessing to be here with you today. Episode 11, y'all. We are just moving along. You know, we just had to take a little reset the other day, and I do that from time to time. Take a break, back up, see what's going on. You know, you got to observe the world with a fresh set of eyes sometimes because there'll be so much going on that can just beat you down. So we don't want to be beat down. We don't want you to be beat down. I don't want to be beat down. We just got to take a break. You know, give yourself a break. You work a little bit and take a little break. But I'm glad you're here. And if this is your first time here at Chaz Wins, what took you so long? You know, I want to know. Email me, chazwins38@gmail.com, chazwins38@gmail.com, or check out the website, whatever, share it with your friends, chazwins.net, baby, .net. You know, that's when you're official, when you got a dot something else, you know, and .net means network, so that's what I want y'all to continue to do, keep on networking and spreading the love, telling your friends and family about it, tell the people you don't like, too. Tell them to come check out Chaz Wins on Grind City TV Network Roku. Episode 11. We got some things going on, as always. I'm always in the kitchen cooking up something in the pot. Always, you know, because you guys give us a lot to think about and a lot to digest. So we're going to do just that. We're going to disseminate what's going on with all this information. We're going to try to put it together in a package that's going to make sense of the world. No, it ain't. Not really. We're just going to just be a damn fool on here. That's what we're going to do. But that's what we're good at, so keep coming back for the foolishness, all right? Hey, we're going to take another quick break, and we'll be back. Get right back into it. Two and two.
So So at this point in my life, I'd done a lot of crazy things, but I had never bought a car from a vending machine, and I thought it was time to check it out. Now, there's my car, the one I picked up way up top. If you squint real hard, you can see it. There it is up there. And at this point so far, everything went well. I mean, this isn't an endorsement for this car company. I just wanted to check out the vending machine. It was pretty dope, y'all. It was fun. It was a good experience. It was something different, you know. So there's the old car. We're going to get rid of that one. It's gone. And the whole process was pretty fun. It's something to do. Get you interactive. I love how all these things are coming together now. And people just getting creative trying to get your money. Look at that. That's my last nickel. Nah, it's pretty cool. They give you a little coin and you simulate the whole experience. So it was pretty cool watching all the machinery. I like machines, cars, anything to do with stuff like that. So for me, it was like a real high point to see this all come together. I mean, you were going to buy the car anyway. I just wanted to see what it was. Yeah, it's kind of gimmicky, but you know what? It felt like I won a prize or something. You know what I mean? And here it comes, coming down the elevator. So, and they leave you alone, let you do your thing. It's like your own experience by yourself. So, again, this ain't really an ad for the car company or anything like that. It's just me going through this experience. And it was pretty cool. It is something different for sure. Do a little paperwork and all that before you get there. So basically, by this point right here, everything's all done. You just going to go pick up your new car. Yeah, you guys know I roll with the heavy hitters, Steel City Heavy Hitters Car Club here in Pittsburgh. And, you know, we are a family car club environment. We get out, have fun. We love cars, any kind. Anybody's welcome. We just want to have fun and be dope and be family. I get out, we have picnics, go out and do some stuff together. Nothing crazy. We're all, you know, older. And we don't do a whole bunch of that crazy hot rod. But we enjoy it. You know what I mean? It's light. Got the pandemic, so you just got to stay creative, stay busy. Love my car group. We're going to be talking more with them. I'm going to get the founder on here, our local chapter here real soon, Brother Don Owens, you know. And yeah, that's the bling, y'all. Comes right out to the door and deliver it right to your hands. And you drive off and go get a ticket.
Yeah, that's right. It's Bats again. Let me tell you something. You know, just the other day, you know, people are getting out of hand with this COVID and all these rules and minding their business and masks and shit. I walked into the store the other day and I was hanging out with Aquaman. I don't ask me why I was hanging out with Aquaman. That's not important right now. Truth of the matter is, you know, Aquaman and I are the only ones that don't have any real superpowers. So we're kind of hanging, you know, back in the day, we used to just hang out on the back of the corner from Wilson Way and Homewood Avenue, you know. That's not important. I'm walking into the store, and this lady looks at me, you know. I walk in like this, right? Because I'm Batman, that's what I do. I walk in, I was going to go get some wings. I walk into the restaurant, and she goes, "Excuse me, sir, you don't have on the mask." I'm looking at her like, don't recognize who I am. I'm Batman. I got a mask on. Don't talk about COVID. I'm nothing like that. I don't need a mask. Why don't you go on back there and make me some wings, Karen? Go clip some coupons or something. Make sure you put some extra wing dust on my wings too while you're back here if you want to be in charge of something. Be in charge of the wings. Make sure you fry them hard too. I don't play around. Worry about my mask. I'm Batman. I've always got a mask on. Listen, people, I know I got an attitude problem. It's you know, thank God it's 420 day. And a matter of fact, I'm taking a day off. I'm gonna sit back, me and Aquaman, we're gonna go get in the bat boat. We're gonna cruise around in the river a little bit. That's right. What, you never saw Batman drink coffee before? How the hell else did I fight crime all damn day long? Speaking of crime, I think I'm gonna run for mayor. What do you think about that? Just think about that, yeah. First of all, everything's going to be black. That's going to be my campaign, just black, a black screen. And it's going to say, vote for Batman. That's what it's going to say, that's all. Just vote for Batman. Think about it, who else can be tough on crime? Me, that's who. That's right. There'll be no more crime. Matter of fact, the police department, everybody's going to be riding around in Batmobiles all over the place, so you don't know if it's me or the regular Popo. But I tell you what, we'll clean up this crime in this city and all of the corruption. Yeah, my campaign, I got it all figured out. I got a good campaign manager, finance guy. I know a guy. He's got my back. Plenty of money. Don't worry about that. So we'll be fine. You know, the first thing I'm going to do, though, as mayor, I'm going to make it illegal for those to keep calling me about my god extended warranty. I've got the Batmobile. I don't need a warranty. I got Alfred to fix everything. Not the white Alfred from the show, but the black Alfred. You know, Morgan Freeman Alfred. That's who I roll with. Anyway, I'm just saying, people, stay in your lane, mind your own business. I got a mask on. If you're a regular person, you gotta wear your mask, whatever kind you have. But I'm Batman, and I can do what I wanna do.
As you can see, they got me out here in this daggone weather again. It's, you know what, I keep on asking them, please give me an inside job. I need a desk. I'm tired of being out here in these elements. There's birds is out here chirping and it's cold, y'all. It's the end of April. It's about to start snowing. Don't put your snow brush away just yet. I think y'all gonna need that in the next couple days. Just let you know. Just be careful out there. It's gonna be icy, you know what I mean? Here we are, and I told you, you know, anything can happen with this weather. You don't believe me. I don't need to be outside out here doing this stuff. Look up the skies, it's gray. You know, I got my wool coat on again, and it's cold, y'all. I keep on telling you. I'm trying to come into the studio. Tired of this out here. You know, it's rainy, it's crappy out here. I drove to work today, my 22s is all dirty. I'm gonna start catching a bus, y'all, because this weather's crazy. That's all. Let me tell you something. Make sure you take your umbrella, bring your snow brush, put on your sunglasses, put on your rubber boots, your rubbers, because you never know. You got to have them. And you'll be prepared. That's all. I ain't even really got to be doing this out here. Y'all know what time it is. Just look outside and just look up in the sky. If you don't get wet, then you ain't gonna need no raincoat. That's all. It's simple. But I'm telling you, it's probably gonna snow today. So just watch out. Be careful out there. You know, don't want that on slippery slope. All right? And again, check my contract, because by now it's my 6th year. I'm supposed to have my own desk by the year 5, and I ain't happy yet. So I'm about to go and start applying for some other jobs. Sesame Street, I don't let your company, somebody's damn show. This ain't working. This network ain't even got a name, y'all. Did y'all notice that? This news network, they ain't got a name, got a channel station, they ain't got nothing. It's like worse than the WB. They just broke around this mug. All right, y'all, take it back.
See, y'all, even the weatherman is disgruntled around here on Chaz Wins. I don't know, it's a theme. It's crazy, but hey, I'm shout out to the people out here holding it down on the ground doing their thing. All of y'all out here, you know, got your stimulus checks, and those who didn't get your stimulus check, I know people still ain't got their check yet. But I know one thing, I think all them stimulus checks, the government, Joe Biden done ran out of money, because I ain't get my income tax yet. It is almost May. So, I think one of y'all got my check. And I'm just saying, I'm thankful, I'm still here, but I need some money. You know what I'm saying? We try to move on and do bigger and better things. You know, I'm trying to upgrade my 22s, you know? I don't know what's after that. They make 24s. I don't know. It's like, I don't even have big rims. That's never been my thing, but it just seemed like sometimes, you know, when you roll on 22s, it seemed like life would be better. And I know I'm using that for a metaphor of sorts of just how when things are good, you know, you just be rolling down the highway. But lately, I ain't even had 22s. I've been running like 20s. You know what I'm saying? It's been kind of bumpy. You know, you feel all the bumps in the road, and it's a struggle, man. It's a struggle. So shout out to y'all to still holding it down, still waiting for them checks. I think our government they're going to have to step up their game. You know what I'm saying? Because more folks is like, look, we got stuff to do, waiting on your stimmy. Yeah, ain't no EBT cards hitting nowhere. You know, Cash App. What we going to do? What are we going to do? I don't know.
Once again, this is your newsman coming to you on location, again, outside where I do not like to be. My contract states that after my fifth year, I will get a desk and I will be on prime time. But yet, look where I'm at. They got me out here under the stars, y'all. I don't even like the country. I'm from the city. And I'm going to have to talk to them about this again. All right, so look, let me just let give you the forecast right here. As you can see, the sun is about to go down. That's what we call sunset. You know, it is what it is. The sun's going to set. It's going to be dark. It's probably going to get cold. That's all I know. It'll be cold tonight. So put a blanket on, put a fire on the fire, whatever. Logs, what you got to do. All I know is that 12 more hours, that sun's going to come right back up, and it's going to be a little bit warmer. It might rain. It might snow. You might want to have your snow brush just in case. We try to let you know everything you need to know about the weather because you just don't know. Take every damn thing. All right, it's cold out here, and I'm getting tired of it, so we'll give me a smoke. We so poor, we ain't got a segment. We don't even got a news call station. We don't even got a channel number. We just out here, just standing outside talking about the weather. And don't nobody care about the weather. Shoot. I'm gonna apply for WB if they still around. Something, BET, somebody. I'm getting on somebody else's network, because y'all suck. I do know this. It's going to get better at some point, so just hang in there. You know, summer is coming. you can shut off the gas if you know they threaten me like, oh, we're going to turn your gas off. I'll be like, shit, it's about to be June. I cook out all summer. You know how we do it, folks. You know what I'm saying? Black folks will threaten to shut off my gas. Shoot, I don't need that gas anymore. I don't like hot showers anyway. Shoot, you know, you old school, and you've been poor, but you be like, I don't need no hot water. I'll just put everything in the microwave. That's kind of sad, y'all. But hey, you know, those of you that have been here, you know what I'm talking about. But you'll do what you gotta do to survive. I'm just saying, we are a resourceful people. You know, we're resilient. But that's all I got for now, y'all. We're gonna be back with you next week, and I want to hear from you. If you got anything to say, comments, you know, we'd love to put you on. You know, like I said, chazwins38@gmail.com. Or you can go to chazwins.net. That's check out the website, and also on Instagram and YouTube and Facebook and Black Planet and Yelp. Do I got a Yelp, Rick? Yelp. Oh, I ain't on Yelp. I guess that's a good thing or a bad thing. I don't know. It ain't like Yelp. See, them Yelp reviews be conflicting because, somebody had a nerve to put a Yelp rating for Taco Bell. Yeah, Taco Bell. Come on, dog. It's Taco Bell. If you ain't out drinking all night, drinking, you know, and the cheap liquor, and if you go into Taco Bell and get your order, don't expect to get like 5-star service. It ain't gonna happen, dog. They their food, think about it. They make up names all the time. Every week, Taco Bell done invented something new that you probably shouldn't be eating. They got like too much cheese on it. Some meat that's probably like grade triple F, you know, that ain't no good. And you when you eat Taco Bell, your hands get that Taco Bell meat stain in your hand, your fingers when you're eating the meat. I mean, y'all know what I'm talking about. It'll be like a day later, your hands still smell like Taco Bell meat. That ain't never good. So when you invent names like Quesalupa, who is a Quesalupa? And somebody gonna put a Yelp rating on Taco Bell, talking about they gave him one up. You know, 1-star or whatever on Taco Bell. It's Taco Bell, man. Come on, y'all. I hate that when people come into McDonald's, they sit up there like they're looking at them. First of all, you on the value page. You on the value menu. Gonna be like, let me get a McChicken. Wait. Is there cheese on? No, there ain't no cheese on no McChicken. Everybody knows that, man. Come on, y'all be doing too much. You might take your ass on over to Chick-fil-A or something because, you know, McDonald's ain't having it. They got the value meal for a reason because people were broke. So don't bring your broke ass in here expecting no nothing fancy. Go on to Chick-fil-A or something, and they'll be happy to take your order, I'm sure. And if you don't got no money, they'll probably pay for it anyway. One of the words, I'm sorry, sir, I'm broke, man. I ain't got no money. Don't worry about it, sir. We're going to take care of that. We're going to take care of your family. You don't have to ever run anything in. Enjoy this delicious sandwich. That's how they are down at Chick-fil-A. I went one time, and they were so nice, it scared me. I thought the police would set me up for something at Chick-fil-A. Like, this is... I don't know, this child support court, somebody waiting around the corner for something. I don't know, they set you up for something.
is ain't nobody that damn nice to come into a restaurant just to get a chicken sandwich. And you know, truth be told, I rock with the original. I don't even like the Wendy's sandwiches or McChicken. I'm the original. The original. KFC, Chicken Little Sandwich. That's the original. That's how I get that old school back in the 80s, y'all. Y'all remember the Chicken Little Sandwiches? Used to get like three of them. Used to come three, a little bun, you know, boom. One no pickle, it was just chicken, bun, and mayonnaise. That was a chicken sandwich, y'all. KFC, bring them original Chicken Littles back. You know what I'm saying? All this other stuff going on, so y'all can have your fancy Chick-fil-A, and y'all can have your Taco Bell be staining your fingers, and God Lord knows what that's doing to your insides. But you know, we also call Taco Hell back in my service days. You know, we go to Taco Bell every Friday. Now you out drinking, ain't nothing else late. You're drinking anyway, having a good time, partying, then you go eat Taco Bell and expect to get up at 5 o'clock in the morning and do some PT the next day. Yeah, not a good look, y'all. Not a good look. So I'm just saying, make better food choices. I did my best to confuse y'all today. I really did. So, but on a more serious note, thanks again for the folks at Grass City TV Network, aka Buttons, because you know you be holding it down, doing some dope things, always in your corner, and you know you give us all something to shoot for. And shout out to Pandemic Press. You know, you guys are doing it big out there too. And all my friends out there in the, down behind the scenes, you know, Jazz Bean Productions, we got a good show coming up real soon. So again, we got some stuff going on behind the scenes. Shout out to Lavender Freddy, you know, the Sunscreen Conspiracy. You know, y'all can Google these names at any time and check out what they're doing, because they're all on social media. But I'm telling you, when everybody starts dropping, starts hitting, when the, you know, y'all going to think that everybody, like the stimulus check or tax return come in, you know how when you get brand new furniture from the dollar store, the cheap store, the cheap furniture? Yeah, that's how we going to be. Sure, that's how I rock anyway. I ain't trying to front, but I'll be at the red, white, and blue store shoot. I'm going, matter of fact, when I'm done here, I'm about to go get me a new suit. Look, I ain't proud. I will wear some hand-me-downs in a minute. Shoot. All right, y'all. That's all I got. I'll talk to you soon. Peace and blessings. Love you. And thanks for hanging out with me today. Don't nobody go nowhere. This is Reverend Johnson, and it's been far too long that I had something to say to you. Now I know everybody's been home with the COVID-19, and you can't get out the church, and you're sick, and you're shut in. I understand that, but you know what? The Lord does not work on goodwill alone. He may give goodwill, but it takes goodwill to get the blessings down from heaven. Hallelujah, somebody say it. Now, I know y'all sitting there waiting on your stimulus checks, and some of y'all done got them. And some of y'all been having all kind of money on the EBT cards. And I tell you, I've been here every Sunday, sitting up here in the church. Ain't nobody been here but just me and Sister Gladys. She's the only one that's been paying her tithes. So let me tell you something. We now take EBT cards in the church, and we got a website, and you can also cash app us. That's right. Cash apps, the cash app sign and dollars for Jesus. That's right, the dollar sign for Jesus. If you want to send money to the church to help keep the lights on, to help keep the heat on, and to help keep the blessings flowing, I'll tell you, brothers and sisters, somebody make a joyful noise. It's been far too long. I didn't even see y'all at Easter, and I missed all the pimp Easter suits. Some of y'all out here running around trying to rap and spit bars like you got some kind of platinum rapper or something. Who do you think you are, Dylan? Let me tell you something. You can't get into heaven with rapping. Only way you're going to get into the pearly gates is with praying. And right now, I'm going to pray that y'all bless this offering and get that money back up here flowing in the church. Remember, cash out for Jesus. I'm Reverend Johnson. I've been watching y'all. And I ain't been too happy. And if you know I ain't happy, the Lord ain't happy either.